Possil Loch and the surrounding wetlands are perhaps one of the best known wildlife habitats existing on the peripheral of any city in Scotland. These wetland communities are the largest remaining areas of their type within Glasgow. The fens and loch support a great diversity of plants, including a number of nationally scarce and threatened species. Historically, these fens and bogs formed part of an extensive system of lochs and marshes that ran across the west central belt of the Scottish lowlands. Currently at 78 acres in size and 50 metres above sea level, the loch was originally thought to occupy a natural basin of water created by a melting glacier. It's now generally believed that mining subsidence was the more probable cause for the formation of the permanent water body we see today. Being so close to the city, the marsh is particularly vulnerable from industrial and residential development. In the mid-19th century, the water level was so severely affected by drainage that the loch was reported to run dry in the summer. Since the 1960s, a series of drainage ditches have been dug to alleviate flooding on the Balmore Road and the build-up of silt blocking water outlets from Lambhill Cemetery complex nearby. Various attempts have been made to control the water level, but as yet have been unsuccessful. The spill-off from the road and drainage from the cemetery has had the effect of turning the marsh into a sump. The excess water brings with it extra nutrients, which can sway the balance of the local ecosystem, encouraging the spread of one plant species over another. The invasive reed sweetgrass is predominant throughout the area, and this plant can smother and displace other less vigorous vegetation that is native to the area. Some marshland species such as grass of Parnassus and adder's tongue fern, bog asphodel, the carnivorous bladderwort, marshwort, and creeping willow have been previously recorded at the site but have now disappeared. The loch contains a central mire of Birch Island, which supports an important number of sphagnum species. A raised bog formation which is in the early stages of forming peat. Many of the species which are firmly established within the reserve have been deliberately introduced, but some have come accidentally from the adjacent canal. Other species, such as cursed buttercup, entered the marsh due to material being brought in to level up the ground for a cottage that once stood within the reserve. It also holds tufted loosestrife, which is listed in the scarce plant atlas. The reed beds are home to many species of invertebrates, including aquatic beetles and dragonflies. Possil Marsh is the most northwesterly known location for the swan mussel, which has been recorded at only 5 sites in Scotland during the last century. The site provides nesting cover and winter grounds for a wide diversity of bird species. A variety of ducks and swans, including the rarer whooper swan, can be seen in its waters. You may catch a glimpse of ospreys resting at the loch on their annual return to the Highland Eyries at Loch Garten and elsewhere. Wagtails, warblers and swallows fly around the marsh before setting in the reeds and willows for cover. A total of 145 species of birds have been recorded, with up to 22 species breeding, including birds such as reed bunting and water rail, which are in decline nationally. These areas are a valuable habitat for many mammals, including mink, otters, the water vole and roe deer, which are being seen in increasing numbers on the marsh each year. Ironically, it is the industrialisation of the local boundary of the loch that has protected and preserved it, and provided safe access for people to course its terrain.
The original path was for the linesmen to walk the line, check the lines. During the storms and that, fuses would blow and they would have to walk the line to see what caused the fuse to blow, you know. It might be a kid throwing a wire up, or it might be a bird kissing another bird, sort of thing. The trees doing, any trees that are growing get cut down. But then the Royal Bank of Scotland took over and they maintained it for a while, you know, and made it a proper path.
In 1954, the marsh was first notified as a site of special scientific interest, and in 1982 was acquired as a gift by the Scottish Wildlife Trust, who carried out improvements, including the building of a circular walkway with access from the canal towpath. It was the first nature reserve in Glasgow to be completely accessible to the disabled. Along the path at the northern end of the loch sits the monument for the high Possil meteorite, which fell in a nearby stone quarry in 1804. The Possil Loch and surrounding wetlands have inspired many natural historians to take up their field of study. For the people of Lambhill, the loch draws the barrier between wild nature and urban civilization, a place holding a thousand tales of man and the natural world blending together.